this is Claire at Restore Fitness Therapies. I hope you're well today. So in this video, I'd like to take you through an exercise called the saw. This is a seated exercise. I think it's actually a really challenging exercise, sort of an intermediate to advanced level. So what we're going to do is provide you with some different options so that even if you're a beginner, you can start to take part in this exercise and start working your way up to those more difficult options. So for this exercise, you'll need your mat probably to sit on. I'm also going to use a block as well and just show you how to use this and why it might suit you. So you're in your seated position. I'll just show you from a sort of forward view to start with. You want to be sitting with your legs probably just about the width of your mat. They don't need to be super wide. If you're flexible and you want to take them wider, I don't think it's going to do you much harm here. But the really important thing is that you're not slouching backwards here. So if I just show you sideways, a lot of us struggle with back strength, and we can't sit up straight in this position, which is where we want to be. We find that we start to go backwards. So the first thing you can try to get yourself into a more upright position is to actually really lift the fleshy bit of buttocks out of the way and behind you, and try to get your seat bones firmly on the mat. Now for some of you that will solve the problem and you'll find that you're nicely upright now. And behind you, use your legs probably, so quite a tough start position, but you are upright. Now if that hasn't helped and you still feel like you're struggling to sit upright and it's straining your back and your legs, this is where your block can become really useful. So we've got these in the Team Up store for you to purchase. If you don't have one immediately, you could just find a solid book or something else to sit on there. Maybe quite a firm cushion might do for now. So if you're looking to sit on a block to improve your posture, there's no point just sitting in the middle of the block because you can still slouch. You need to sort of shimmy your bottom over the edge so you sort of feel the seat bones just tip over. And what I find is the back of the block just starts to lift slightly. And what that does is pushes the middle of my back forwards, keeps my hips back, and now I can sit up quite comfortably. And for me, that actually takes a lot of strain out of my quad muscles here as well. So have a little experiment with that. Maybe use a mirror again at home or your phone camera like I'm doing now, just to check out your own posture and see if you can find this nice tall seated position to start with here, okay? So I'm going to take the block away just to show you this as it is here. So for our saw, let's start with a nice easy option here. She says easy option. We're going to put the hands in a prayer position and attach the thumbs to the sternum. And we want to keep the shoulder blades back in the body. So I'm breathing in to prepare. As I breathe out, I'm rotating to one side. Now I'm keeping my thumbs attached to the chest and I'm keeping my chin above the fingertips. And then when I want to breathe in, I come back to the centre. So breathe out, engage the core, rotate the upper body, breathe in and return. Now I'm flexing my feet and pointing my toes up towards the sky so that all the muscles in my legs are engaged and working hard as well. Now keep sense checking that your shoulder blades haven't started to slump and your upper body has come forward. You want to keep this distance between your ribs and your hips, and that means your core muscles are working and your back chain, the muscles in your back, are also working hard, okay? So you're breathing out to rotate, breathing in to come back. Breathing out to rotate, breathing in to come back. And you'd be looking to maybe go anywhere between about 3 and 8 times on each side. If you need to stop and take a break as your legs are getting tired, that's fine. Just pop the soles of the feet together in a nice relaxed sort of diamond shape. That will just ease off the legs. And if it's your back that's struggling a bit, just let yourself rest forward for a moment. Feel a bit of stretch and then come back into position, okay? So in this exercise, like I said, we're looking to work these core muscles. Because of the rotation, when you get out to the edges, you should feel this in the muscles at the side of the body, your oblique muscles here working hard, as well as these leg muscles working the back. And you're having to think really hard about your upper body posture as well, okay? So that is your first option, that's your starting point here. If you feel you can do a little bit more, working you towards the full saw exercise, you can take your arms out to this W position here. So a little bit more difficult because you lose your frame of reference from the hands and you've got to keep your shoulder blades really close. And again, as you breathe out, you're rotating, keeping the shoulder blades close and breathing in to return. Everything else is exactly the same. Breathing out to rotate, breathing in to return, okay? And then our most difficult arm option, as you would do in the full saw, is to have both your arms completely outstretched. Now, what you're looking to do here again is imagine you've got a broomstick across your back and try to keep your shoulder blades close. What you want to avoid happening is one arm coming across the body, sort of tricking you into thinking that you're moving further, because you're not, unfortunately. But you want to keep those shoulder blades close, rotate. So now your upper back is working a lot harder, and then you're breathing in to return, okay? So those are your different arm options here. Now with the legs, what we're looking to do now is create a little bit of reach towards our toes. And I think you could add in the reach and the leg motion, whatever arm position you're choosing to go for, okay? So I'm gonna show you from the easiest option here with our fingertips sort of together in our prayer position. So again, flex those feet, lengthen the legs out, sitting tall, shoulder blades back to start. You're breathing in to prepare. As you breathe out, you rotate, and then you're gonna lean little finger to little toe, head down, and little finger of the back hand up towards the ceiling, and then breathe in to come back. So breathe out, rotate and lean. Breathe in, come back. Breathe out, rotate and lean. Breathe in, come back. Breathe out, rotate and lean. Breathe in, come back. And you can do exactly the same thing with the hands in your W position, or your lengthened arms. This is our full saw. So again, I'm just gonna put my feet together, give my legs a little bit of a rest, because that's a really tough position to be in there. And then we're gonna show you more of the saw. So, full saw exercise, same leg position, arms outstretched here, breathing in to prepare. As you breathe out, rotate the body, lean down. This time I'm gonna pulse twice. Breathe in, breathe out. Side is pretty tough going, so start with lower numbers. You're going to feel this in the legs quite a lot, but it's a great little exercise, really good for rotation of the spine. So if you're stiff in your middle back, this will really help you to get some movement here. It's great for your upper body posture, because you're thinking about keeping your chest open and using your back muscles to hold yourself up here. And you also get quite a bit of nifty leg strengthening without realizing it as well. So lots going on there, quite a tough exercise. I can just feel myself starting to sweat a little bit there. So a really good one to have a go at. Always start with the easiest option and work yourself up. You don't want to strain yourself into an advanced option. And if you start with the easy option, you'll build the correct strength in the correct areas that will enable you to move on. So have a little go at that, start at the beginning, give us a shout if you have any trouble, and we'll try and do a follow-up video for anyone who needs it. Okay, good luck with that one.